They were all 9 years old, and if there had been a day 7 years ago when the sun came out for an hour and showed its face to the stunned world, they could not recall, right? This is what I have told you. They were all 9 years old. All these children were 9 years old. 9 years old. And if there had been a day 7 years ago, 7 years ago, if there was a day when the sun had come, when the sun came out for an hour and had shown its face, then they don't remember that. They can't recall it. They don't remember the sun at all. Now let us move to the next paragraph. Sometimes at night she heard them stir in remembrance, and she knew they were dreaming and remembering gold or a yellow crayon or a coin large enough to buy the world with. So you can see over there, sometimes at night these children, sometimes all these children, all the children from the Venus, these small children, those who were 9 years old. Now, Margaret is saying this. Sometimes at night she heard them. Margaret used to hear them stir in remembrance. They used to stir. They were remembering. And she knew they were dreaming. Who knew? Margaret knew that they were dreaming and remembering gold. Because they don't know life, isn't it? They don't know what the sun is. They only remember these type of things, artificial things. They were remembering of gold or a yellow crayon or a coin large enough, a huge coin with which they can buy the world with. Okay, so this is what they are dreaming about. Other than these artificial things, nothing they know about the natural things. Sun is something which is natural that they don't know. This is what the narrator is showing over here. Okay, these children who were brought up on the planet Venus, they only know, they have only come across with all artificial things around, but they have never come across any natural thing. The only thing what they see is after only 7 years, they see the sun. She knew they thought they remembered a warmness, like a blushing in the face, in the body, in the arms and legs and trembling hands. But then they always awoke to the tatting drum, the endless shaking down of clear bead necklaces upon the roof, the walk, the gardens, the forest, and their dreams were gone. So she knew they thought they remembered a warmness. She knew they thought they just remembered a warmness, like a blushing in the face. This is what. Now, how do we people wake up in the morning? We wake up with the sun's light, isn't it? Early in the morning, we get the brightness of the sun. With that brightness, we all wake up. Isn't it? So it enters through our blinds, isn't it, inside the house, and with that warmth we all wake up. So that is known to Margaret. Margaret knows about it. She knew they thought they remembered a warmness, like a blushing in the face, in the body, in the arms and legs and trembling hands. So this is the warmth of the sun. But then they always, who are they? The children, these other children, they always awoke to the tatting drum. They got up with certain sounds inside the house, tatting drum, the endless shaking down of clear bead necklaces upon the roof, then the walk, the gardens, the forest, and their dreams were gone. So like that, they used to wake up. So they never woke up with the brightness of the sun. All day yesterday, they had read in class about the sun. So in the class, they got prepared themselves. They were waiting. The scientist told them that they are going to receive the sun. They are going to see the sun after 7 years. So they were all waiting for the sun and they were getting prepared by reading about the sun. About how like a lemon it was. So this was taught to the children, that the sun was of the lemon shape. It was like the lemon, and how hot it was, very hot. And they had written small stories or essays or poems about it. I think the sun is a flower that blooms for just 1 hour. So these are the things what they wrote, right? That the sun is a flower and that blooms for just 1 hour. So these are their idea about the sun, because they never had seen sun. But that was not the case with Margaret. Margaret, since she lived in Ohio until she was 5 years old, she has many memories of the sun, and the sun continues to fascinate her. Sun continues to fascinate Margaret. Margaret And she never likes to participate in any of these classroom activities told over here, that where they don't include the sun. She has been in a depressed state over here on Venus. She didn't like the life over here on Venus. Okay, that is what she felt over here on Venus. That was Margaret's poem read in a quiet voice in the still classroom while the rain was falling outside. So this line written over here was Margaret's poem, because she was fascinated about the poem and they had written small stories. The poem is about the sun. The sun is like the sun is like a lemon, it was, and how hot it is. So this is the thing, these are the things which fascinated Margaret. But not like what the children believe. The children believed, according to them, the sun is a flower that blooms for just 1 hour. That is what their concept was. She wanted, for everything, she wanted the involvement of the sun. She was fascinated with the sun. And she was just waiting, watching near the window, standing near the window, watching for the sun. That was Margaret's poem, read in a quiet voice in the still classroom while the rain was falling outside. When it was raining outside in the still classroom, silent classroom, they read this particular poem. Ah, you didn't write that, protested one of the boys. So one of the boys said that you didn't write that poem. I did, said Margaret. I did. So Margaret said, yes, I wrote the poem, she said. William, said the teacher. But that was yesterday. So that is William's, but that was yesterday. Now the rain was slackening. So this had happened the previous day. Now the rain was slackening and the children were crushed in the great thick windows. Okay, so William was the one who spoke over here, isn't it? William was the one who spoke over here, said that it was not written by Margaret. And there the teacher called William, and we are winding with the speech or whatever had taken place the previous day. Now, we are moving to the next day's event from here. Now, the rain was slackening and the children were crushed in the great thick windows. They were all watching the rain. It was slackening over here. The children were crushed in the thick windows. Where's teacher? They were searching out for the teacher. Teacher was not there. She'll be back. So this was told to them. She had better hurry. We'll miss it. So they all wanted to hurry up. They wanted to see the sun, because they were all waiting for the teacher to come so that they can move ahead and see the sun. They turned on themselves like a feverish wheel, all tumbling spokes. So they all turned by themselves like a feverish wheel, like the wheel, all tumbling spokes, the spoke of the wheel. These children all turned themselves. They started to move to see the sun. They were making a move from there. Margaret stood alone. She didn't participate. She didn't get involved with the children. She stood all alone over there. She was a very frail girl who looked as if she had been lost in the rain for years, and the rain had washed out the blue from her eyes and the red from her mouth and the yellow from her hair. So that is what it is shown over here. This is the description of the little girl who looked very pale in appearance. She was looking very pale. That is the description given. That is what you can understand about her. She was a very frail girl who looked as if she had been lost. She was lost in the rain. She was totally lost for years, and the rain had washed out. And it looked as if the rain had washed out the blue from her eyes, the color from her eyes, the red from her mouth, the yellow from her hair. So totally she was looking pale. This is what the line says. Let us move to the next. She was an old photograph dusted from an album, whitened away, and if she spoke at all, her voice would be a ghost. Now she stood separate, staring at the rain and the loud, wet world beyond a huge glass. Now, overall, how she was looking over here, that is what is being described over here. Photograph dusted from an album. So white and very pale. Pale, she was looking at the, on top, she was looking depressed. She was in a depressed state over here on Venus. That is what is shown by the author. And if at all she spoke anything at all, her voice would be as if like a ghost she spoke, right? So no color at all in her life. She was very pale. That is how she was looking. She was depressed. I told you she was fascinated with the sun, and wherein she was not finding sun, she was totally all the more depressed over here. Now she stood separate, staring at the rain and the loud, wet world beyond the huge glass. So she was staying away from all others, and she was looking at the loud, wet world beyond a huge glass through the window. She was looking at the wet world. This is what she was doing. This what she normally used to do. "What are you looking at?" said William. So again, William is asking her, "What are you looking at?" asked William. Margaret said nothing. She didn't answer to his question. "Speak when you are spoken to."